So I just have the pleasure of telling everybody about what exactly the Pediatric Oncology Eastman Mediterranean group is about. So this group was, a lot of you may have heard about it, but I'm sure people don't know the details. So this group was conceived in nearly 10 years ago and initiated in 2013 in collaboration with the St. Jude Research Hospital in States. Essentially, the plan was to have a cooperative platform for physicians, scientists, and healthcare professionals from institutions in the Eastern and Mediterranean area. The idea being that every geographical area probably has problems common to them, and this whole area would have some common problems. And of course, every country is different, but possibly one can get together to help solve problems which are problematic in a certain area. The problems we have, Canada is not going to have these problems. So let's go take it from there. And the goal was to share medical and scientific experience and facilitate cooperative initiatives, essentially to optimize the care of pediatric oncology patients. So if you look at the Middle East and Eastern, all this area, the population is very high, the highly populated area of the globe with a population of more than 2 billion. And at this point of time, there are 28 countries which are member groups of OEM with about 119 centers. So I'm not going to read out the countries. You can see for yourself that there are a large number of countries and centers who are currently members of this group. The current status in the last so many years, we have more than 700 members from 130 centers across 28 countries. So what exactly do we say that we have a country? We're not going to go into this slide, but this is just to let you know that every country is represented depending either by the way the country wants it, either by a vote or through their oncology chapter, etc. And the number of people representing each country is proportionate to the population. Obviously, India, we're a huge population. So we are three of us who represent the country. So coming into what POEM really wants to do, there's a vision. The vision is to be the leading collaborative group in the East and Mediterranean region to get all the countries together and do it together. And we all know when you do things together, you succeed. Mission is to improve care, research, training, and advocacy in the East and Mediterranean region by means of integrated teamwork. And this is very important because, you know, some place may have a better, maybe better in one thing and less in the other. So if we help each other, we always win. And the goal is to share experiences, initiate cooperative trials, and establish common strategies to achieve optimization of care. So if you look at the membership, when we started off in about 2013 or so, at that time just 200 people were enrolled, which is naturally the people who were on board, etc. And gradually it has increased and exponentially so over the last 1.5 to 2 years, with where the growth has been by a good 49%. And 5 new countries joined POEM in the last 1 year, and the names are written there, which means they're expanding. And hopefully soon the whole area will be under POEM, or rather not under, people will be members of the group. So if you look at membership by specialty, obviously most are doctors. Nurses are encouraged, and 210 nurses is a good number. We've also been encouraging other healthcare workers like pharmacists, researchers, data managers, and nutritionists to register in order to them. So we have, you know, extra training for the rest of the personnel as well. So if you look at the activities, the most important activities have been education, capacity building, clinical care, and scientific advancement. So if you look at education, what has been happening? So we've had a few workshops in various areas and a couple of scientific meetings as well. We've had a palliative care workshop, a nursing workshop, nutrition workshop, infection control. The first scientific meeting was held in Muscat, Oman, about 5 odd years ago. And the second scientific meeting was held in 2019 in Armenia. And last year, we've had just virtual workshops. One was a nursing workshop, And one was a methodology in cancer research and industries. And this workshop was really applauded, and people who attended were really happy with this workshop. Then coming to capacity building, which includes training for nurses and other things, clinical infrastructure, and improvement of research infrastructure. So training and capacity building, at the moment, there are three important sites, which is in Egypt, Lebanon, and Jordan. I'm sure a lot of you will wonder why India is not there on the map. We have institutes in India have given their name to be training centers, but unfortunately, owing to the geopolitical problem, it's not very easy for people from, you know, to go to every country where they may want to go. So these centers train physicians and for a year or 2 years, depending on the program, and then they can go back to their own country and meet a trained oncologist and help there. Just for an example, a lot of people from Syria and Palestine, which we all know, have been totally ravaged by war for the last so many years, have been trained at Lebanon and have gone back to improve the structure. So there's training capacity and capacity building, mixed method nursing program, which means virtual as well as physical have been done. And the need specific on-site nursing training have been done depending on the need of the hospital. Clinical twinning project, research infrastructure is the plan for improvement. Lastly, you have the clinical science and scientific advancement. I think the most important is the case discussions, most relevant for everybody because this is virtual. And anyone who has attended these would know how great it is. And I would actually tell younger faculty and people, fellows who might be listening, that this is something which you really should attend because this is twice a month. You can do any type of tumor is done. You just present the tumor. You have people from all larger centers across the globe who help give opinion. And in case of need, the pathology, x-rays, radiology can be reviewed by experts from, which usually is sent to an expert at St. Jude to get a good opinion. And it has done amazingly well with these discussions. Are really, people look forward to them. Clinical and research studies. So at the moment, they're facilitating member-driven collaborative research studies to connect researchers, support an idea, and provide scientific input. So this does not give money, but supposing someone has an idea, like Ramandeep and Dr. Paramesh just mentioned, someone has an idea, you do not really know how to write it, or you have a basic idea of how to write it, but this group with mentors will help them put it in a proper manner, proper statistical advice, so your study can be done in a planned in an excellent manner, and obviously if you plan it well, your results and outcome will be good. Pathology twinning program, as I said, if you do not have a good pathologist, the slides can be sent to a place where a good pathologist is available. And two protocols have been started under the group. One is the acute lymphoblastic leukemia resource adjusted protocol, which has been started by Dr. Imam in Egypt. And a retinoblastoma collaborative multi-institutional protocol has also been established. Publications have started from the group as such. And in last year, the impact of COVID has already been given, and what the group did to help out during the COVID, what were the adaptations done when COVID came into being. So future events in 2021, it's unlikely that a physical meeting will be possible, but a research methodology workshop is being planned. Of course, business meetings keep occurring, so that's not really relevant. There will be a third scientific meeting, which will be after the one which was held in Armenia 2 years ago, hopefully in 2022. I am quite optimistic that the pandemic is not going to last in 2022. So this will obviously grow and become more meetings will be in the offing. So there are plenty of opportunities for capacity assessment. There's training program, not only for doctors, even for nurses, reference centers, networks and pathways. Especially, this may not be relevant to people from India who are attending the conference, but you don't forget. So there are a lot of very tiny countries in the Middle Eastern areas where they are not able to have all access. They may not have a PET scan. So this, the group is going to help a person go from one country to the next to enable them to get a PET scan done. So that is important to have a network and a proper referral pathway. Implementation of studies, like I said, two studies are already underway. Prospective therapeutic studies are being planned, which includes one on metabolic therapy and repurposing medicine. And of course, biological studies, which is really required to know why there are different problems in different parts of the globe, would be the next step. The force behind the POEM group. There are two ladies, Seema Jeha and Raya Sao, who are the real driving force behind this group. And one would say hats off to both of them for bringing and doing the lion's share of what the, where the group has reached today. The current chairperson is Dr. Aseem Belgami, who is also a big driving force. And currently, he's the president of the POEM group. And his ideas and his vision needs to be applauded. There are people who work behind quietly who do a lot of work. And I would like to say Dolly Naun, who's the scientific committee coordinator, is amazing the way she does everything. And Anas, who's the central group coordinator, who does all the background work required to keep a group running. And honestly, he's not here, but it's hats off how he manages to find the time. POEM is now on Twitter. One can follow them. Information is available. And I have been part of POEM as a sort of representing India along with Colonel Rao and Dr. Girish Chinnaswamy for the last few years. And we have seen it grow. And I would encourage people from this part of the world globe who could come under the POEM group to join POEM, because it is extremely helpful for the younger people. One can easily do a lot of online education, which especially not only these days because of the pandemic, otherwise also is very helpful. And with that, I thank you all for a very patient listening.